Welcome to Tech in a Car, and I'm really excited today because I'm about to get in a Waymo driverless car and use it as a taxi service from here outside this Best Buy in Phoenix, Arizona, here in the US, to go to a bar. And then I'm gonna use it to come back because Google says their Waymo driverless taxi system can be used to do your shopping, stop and get a coffee, and use it like your own personal car. So let's try it out and see how it works. Please do subscribe and give me a like if you enjoy the video, because subscriptions really help me grow and help me get bigger audience and more access to cars. Now, this is the ultimate intersection of technology and cars that drive themselves. Cars nowadays have lots of technology which are almost able to drive themselves. The latest cars, like the Lucid Air, like the Rivian R1T, and of course Tesla, can almost drive themselves, but they're not quite there. But these cars are truly driverless, and this car's going to collect me without a driver, take me to a bar and bring me back, and we're going to try it out here on the channel. How exciting is that? So here it is. Here is the self-driving car. Pretty cool. So let's try it out. So the way this works is, here's the car. You can see all the sensors around it, which allow it to drive itself. And you can see at the top here, it's got my initials, so I know it's for me. Pretty cool, right? Here's the LiDAR and the cameras. And then in the app, I press unlock and the doors unlock.
Hello, Oliver.
Start ride. And let's go.
Hello, from Waymo.
So here I am inside Google's self-driving car. This car is run by Waymo, which is a company which came from Google. And as you can see, there's nobody in the car. I'm just sitting here in the passenger seat. So I could sit in the back seat, but I'm sitting here in the passenger seat. This is the view from inside the passenger seat. The traffic light's red, so we can't go anywhere. This is an EV, a Jaguar EV I-Pace. You can see the screen here telling me we'll be there in 4 minutes. So I've decided to do a round trip in this car. So across the junction, and off we go down the road. And we're almost here at our first stop, which is Circle K. And we're doing a round trip, like I said, so I'm getting to see bits of Phoenix. In fact, this is kind of like a tour. I could just drive this around in a private tour all around the city. And you might be thinking, how do I feel? Do I feel safe in here? Absolutely, I do. I mean, just, I don't feel concerned about my safety. This car knows exactly where it's going. Kind of funny that the mirror is set for the driver position. Obviously, Waymo do have support drivers that come out, as I've seen myself, but it's just funny that the mirror is the mirror is set to the driver. So we're almost at our first stop on our round trip. So this journey is about $11. So the car's pulling over now.
Pulled over. There's Circle K. Pulled over.
You're here. Please make sure it's clear before exiting.
So I can get out the car now if I want to, or I can resume the ride. So obviously in this particular situation, I don't actually want to get out here. So let's press the resume ride button and we'll continue to our next location, which we have. So this is interesting. There's traffic here. And you can see we're coming across, turning right there.
This is quite a surreal experience, but if somebody that loves technology and loves cars, this is a fantastic, fantastic experience to see. Now inside the car here, there's all kinds of other technology. We have what looks very much like a Microsoft Kinect sensor, which they're using to see inside the car. It says Guardian Seeing Machines on it. I don't know whether that should scare me or not. It makes me think of the Terminator. And this car is just going along here. So obviously Waymo support can see me sitting here in the car. They can check on the car, they can check on status. They might even be watching now. So hi, if you're watching. So if you leave your phone in the car,
in the back there, or even in the front here, these cameras can see everything that's going on. They can see who's sitting in the car. They obviously know the billing information because you set it up to pay by card. So they know if you're stealing something from the car that's being left behind, you're doing it and you're being caught red-handed. There's no question about that. As we sit at these traffic lights here, we're turning right on a red here. Once again, nobody sitting in the driver's seat. Self-driving cars are very much the future because they take away all of the human risks of driving. So you don't have to worry about somebody pulling out and hitting you because they're tired or fatigued, because a car is driving for itself. On a trip like from here to Los Angeles, from Phoenix to Los Angeles, a trip that takes about 5 hours, up to maybe 6-7 hours, depending on the traffic and the weather conditions, you're going to get fatigued, you're going to get tired, and people are going to make mistakes. Whether it's just, you know, being tired and not noticing somebody pulling out, it's going to affect your ability to drive safely. And even if you get to where you're going safely, you're still going to be fatigued and maybe need to stop for a break. Well, in this car, you could have a nap, you could fall asleep. Stop when you need a break, if you need to use the bathroom, and...
almost to your drop-off.
That's check it. The app for walk- so this is interesting. There are people who are about to cross the road and the car stopped itself because it was worried that they would walk in front of the car, so it actually stopped before that happened. How cool is that? It really is actually a great example of showing how aware the car is of what is going on around you. I mean, like, how cool is that? This technology is outstanding. It really is. To see how this all works. And, you know, it's exciting to see as well that we have this extra safety and this extra sense of security that can come from this. I have no, like I said, no qualms sitting here in a car talking to the camera. You can see there's two screens actually. There's a screen here with USB so you can plug in and charge your device, and then in the front there's another screen. So super cool, driving yourself without anybody in the car. And if you think about it, these cars and the technology in these cars is really revolutionary. The fact that they've been programmed by Google to work without anybody in the car. Now, these roads have actually been mapped by Google. There are specific areas where they work, and so that means that it's only available in certain areas right now, certain areas of Phoenix, downtown where we are now, and in the southeast corner of Phoenix, also San Francisco, and it's coming to Los Angeles soon. Good luck in Los Angeles with the drivers in LA. But yeah, I mean, look, we're going along 40 miles an hour, 3 minutes to drop off. We're in auto mode. Just super, super cool and super futuristic. Green light, no problems there. Driving along here and nobody behind the wheel. Just like a Jaguar is a wildcat, this car is not controlled by anybody except for by itself. This is technology in the car. I mean, this is the ultimate car. This is a 10-minute ride that I've shown you here, assuming I do put the whole ride in. We might edit it out, but I mean, you know, how awesome is that? Look at this. And the car's going to pull over here and stop. And the car's going to drive off. Here it goes. Very impressive. So I had a drive in the Waymo self-driving car, but I left my phone in the car. So I'm now going to collect it. So I got my phone back. That was totally accidental. I obviously didn't mean to leave my phone back in the car, but I called up Waymo support and somebody came out, got my phone, and that's fantastic. So if you ever lose your phone, now you know what happens. Thank you to support. Thank you to the guys from the support team that came and got it. So that's how Waymo's driverless car system works. So I left my phone behind. I contacted Waymo through the app. They sent some people out to find the car, to check for my phone. They let me know. And then I had a choice of having delivered to my address here in Phoenix, Arizona, or going to collect it. I had the car with me, my car. So I went and collected it. So that's how I did it. But nice to know that worked. If you're worried about safety, once this rollout plays in, if you're busier with more customers, don't forget there are cameras inside the car. So Google knows
who's been in the car, they've got the details. So if somebody did steal your phone, they'd literally be caught red-handed. So it'd be pretty secure, actually, arguably more secure than any other in-car dash cam system, because the fact is, being totally automated, they need to know exactly what's going on. In terms of using the app, it was really simple. I put in my location, the car came to me just like an Uber, just like a Lyft. Price-wise, it was actually cheaper than Uber or Lyft, but I suspect that might change as it rolls out and they get busier and busier and busier. And it's just really easy, really simple. Very, very interesting experience to see it working, to get to use it. And I'm sure we'll see more of driverless cars as time progresses, in fact, as Waymo expands across the US. I hope you found this video useful. Please do give me a like and please do subscribe. And if you have any questions about Waymo, have a look down here and let me know and I'll answer.